Hello. I am sorry, this steering wheel is going to be in the way. I really need to get a little thing for the car to put my phone in so it's not in this awkward position. But I am just rolling through to say hi real quick. I know it's been a minute. There's just been a lot going on. This whole summer has just been really super busy, but I just got back from speed bumps, this town and its speed bumps. I just got back from vacation with my mom and two of my aunts. We go to, we've been going to Cape Cod in September for the last 3 years, and I think we're gonna do it again next year. There's still some places that we haven't, there's some places we haven't eaten at, some places we still need to hit up, so hopefully we'll be able to do that next year. One of my aunts wants to join in on the fun, but instead of going where the rest of us normally go, she's like, let's go to France. I want to go to France, which is perfectly fine, but I'm, in all honesty, I don't know if I can take a whole bunch of time in France with that many people, you know what I mean? Like, and they're all, I don't know. It's special. So there was that, and then Mom and I just got back, Thursday, technically Friday morning. It was like 2 a.m. Are you gonna go? Please go. Thank you. So we got back 2 a.m. Because we live really far away from the airport, because again, we live in the middle of nowhere. And then the next day was busy, and then we had a celebration of life the next day after that, which was Saturday. And that was, it was like 4 hours long, but it was worth it. It was so beautifully done. And, you know, it's honestly, I prefer that over a regular funeral. Like, I'd been to more funerals by the time I was 10 years old than most people will go to in their entire lifetime. So, it's, I don't know, this was just a very different, different kind of thing. It was a change of pace with regard to what I'm used to in these types of situations. And then Sunday, the gentleman, he's one of the pastors and stuff. His wife was the one that passed away. He spoke at church, so I made sure to go, because I really only went for him, because if he was not going to be there that day, I probably would have stayed home too, because I was just exhausted. And then today, sorry, this thing is really in the way. I've got to find a better solution. Today, my dad had surgery on his knee, and so I actually just got my parents back to the house, and now I'm running back out to go pick up his meds because they weren't ready yet, and I didn't want him to have to wait another 30 minutes or so to go home. He was fine, but still, like, you know how it is when you've had surgery and you're in the car and people want to make all kinds of stops, and it's, no, I wouldn't want somebody to do that to me, so I wasn't going to do that to him or to anybody else, really. So yeah, it's just been kind of busy, so the next few days will be just really taking care of my dad, making sure that he's all right. It's been busy, so I probably won't really get any rest until the weekend, but whatever, it's fine, it's all fine. You know that little meme of the dog in the hat, that's, I think he's sitting in a bar and everything on him or everything around him is on fire, and he's just like, it's fine. that has been my life for the last few months. Just, it's fine, it's gonna be okay. So like I said, it'll just be, the rest of this week is really just taking care of my dad and making sure that he is okay. And it'll be easy to take care of him because I've actually been back home for a minute now, and I really wasn't planning to be back this long, but I have only child guilt. And my parents are older. They're not invalid by any means, but it's weird when you see your parents getting older, because my parents are in their 70s, and they don't look it, but all kinds of stuff has been happening, and I just don't feel comfortable leaving them by themselves. Like, I feel like this would be the wrong time in my life and in theirs for me to be living halfway around the world, you know what I mean? My mom is so funny. She's just like, you know, you're never gonna get married here. And I'm like, I know, so I need for y'all to get it together so I can get up and get out, you know? And so she's just like, you don't have to stay here for us. And I know that I don't, you know, if I could pick up and leave tomorrow if I wanted to, but I feel like I need to be, like, I don't trust anybody else to take care of them, you know what I mean? And I don't have siblings. We don't live near family. We've never lived near family my whole entire life. I'm a military kid, so, you know, the closest family we have is maybe about 4 hours away, and even still, like, we don't make it out that way very often, and, we're just kind of, my dad's side of the family's kind of spread out, mostly, well, some of them are still in Mississippi, and then, you know, like, just, you know, various places throughout the states. And my mom's side of the family, I've mentioned it before, they're all still in Canada. So we're, you know, we've just always lived far away from everybody else. And even, I don't know, it's just like you love family, but I don't trust anybody to take care of my parents the way that I would. You know, one day I'll leave, but for right now, or one day I'll leave again. But for right now, I'm where I'm supposed to be, and I'm actually fairly content with that, probably for the first time in quite some time. I was going to say something else about this, but I can't remember what I was going to say. That's pretty much it. But if you ever, it's going to happen eventually, but, when you see, like, a huge change of scenery, that means that I've finally let go of only child guilt and was just like, all right, y'all, I'm leaving again. I'll see y'all when I see you, you know? But I don't know. And being at home has actually been good for all of us over the last few... It's been a few years. It's been over the last few years since I came back. And... you know, it's been good in several different ways, but one of them is because all three of us have gone through, you know, major illnesses and had surgeries, and then, like, my dad and I both have ongoing illnesses. My mom is the oldest person in the house and is the healthiest person in the house, has always been the healthiest person in the house. I don't know if it's because she's a retired RN, and she's just immune to everything at this point, because she was an RN for, like, over 40 years, and so, her immune system is fantastic. This is the woman that can, you know, eat something that's been in the fridge for, like, a week, whereas, and be perfectly fine, like, stomach of steel, whereas, you know, if it's been 2 days, if Dad or I try to eat anything, we are sick. Like, it's just, she's so healthy, and that's a great thing. And I'm saying that, but she actually had cancer a few years ago. She had breast cancer, and it was, I say it was funny, not ha-ha, but when she ended up having cancer, we were really super surprised, because there's no family history of it at all on her side, but there's a ton of it on my dad's side, and I've had a couple of scares myself, so we honestly, like, we thought that I would have cancer before she ever would, you know, and so I'm glad that I was home for that, because if I weren't home for that, I still would have been home for that, you know. I would have left, you know, whatever job, house, all that stuff, you know, I would have left it behind, and I would have been home anyway, you know. And then the same with my dad, he ended up with kidney disease and some other things, you know, other stuff that they deal with just being older, you know. And then I have a bunch of my own stuff that I've been dealing with for the last 9 9 or 10 years, but I wasn't, like, you know, it's only been in the last few years that it's really been, like, really an issue and stuff. So, yeah, I mean, we all just, you know, we all have our things that we've gone through, and if I hadn't been here for it, you know, if I hadn't been here when all of these things had happened, I still would have been here, you know? So it was just, it's just in the cards for me to be home right now, and that's okay. You know, it's really okay. You know how a lot of times people, especially being older too, like when people come home, you know, and folks are just like, oh, you know, I've never experienced that. Everybody that knows me, that knows my parents, you know, nobody's ever said anything about me coming home. And probably because half of them wish that they could go home, honestly. But, you know, life, that's all it is. It's life. Sometimes the things that you think are, you know, a setback can actually end up being a blessing, you know. And, like, for me, I never wanted to come back here, you know, not to live. And even now, like, you know, if my parents ever decide to move away, which I'm really actively trying to convince them to do, especially when winter rolls around, because sometimes the winters here are really rough. You know, if my parents move away, or, you know, if they leave by other means, I'm the only reason that anybody would ever see me back here again is for weddings and funerals, honestly. It's just not my favorite place. There are far worse places in the world, though. That is for sure. But, yeah. So, I don't know. But I am getting ready to get off the highway. I am almost at my destination. And so, I just wanted to come on for a minute and say hi. Because I know it's been a little bit since I've posted a video. And just to kind of tell you why. Just a little life update. I'm not necessarily the person that's an open book. You know what I mean? Like, I don't necessarily tell people all of my business, even people that I've been friends with for like 20, 30 years. They don't know everything about me. They're lucky if they know a quarter, you know, but I felt like this was, you know, it's been a rough few months. And so I just thought I would share a little bit because, you know, a lot of times we come on here and we're just like, you know, yes, handbags and buying this, that, and the other, and everything is great and blah, 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 but everything's not always great. It's life. It's life, and it happens whether you wanted to or not. You know, different situations are going to come up all the time, you know. Some are going to be good. Some are going to be bad. Some of them are going to be somewhere in the middle, right in that gray area, you know, but it is what it is, and it is what you make of it, you know. I could be, you know, we all could be depressed in our situations, regardless of how good it looks on the outside to other people. But again, it's all in how you take it. It's all about what you make out of the situations that you're placed in or that you put yourself in. So yeah, that is pretty much it. I will have a video coming out later in the week. I'm waiting for one more package to come in because I got off of Ban Island on September 1st, lost my mind, and I am currently back on the island. I didn't really spend as much as I had originally intended to, which turns out to be a good thing. That's a good thing, because now I can put that towards what I want for my birthday in November. So, you know, just making money and saving money until that happens. So yeah, so now I am at my local Walmart, which I hate Walmart. Hate it with a passion, but again, when you live in the middle of nowhere, you do what you gotta do, because the closest Target is 45 miles away, and that sucks, but that's okay. It's okay. Again, the choices we make, right? So, I'm going to let you guys go, but be on the lookout later in the week for another video from me. I hope that you are all doing well, and I will talk to you again soon. Bye.